Hello everyone, this is BCS Buster, and welcome back to Let's Play Breath of Fire 2. Well, last time we learned more about Sten's past, and he got into it with a guy named Trubo, which I still think is a misprint translation for Turbo, but nonetheless. They got into a fight on the big bridge, a clash on the big bridge, if you will, and they both fell down, and now they've decided to, well, they've rekindled and they're friends again, and now they're going to find a way to save the princess from Shupukay. And we definitely need to heal up. So if we go over here, all of a sudden, when they drank the clean water, we regained all their strength. So I don't know who we is or they is, because there's only one of us, and we have these guys here that are just cranking the wheels just like before. Oh, that's really funny. I was hoping I could go back and buy some items, but I'd forgotten the bridge was out, as Arnold so delicately put it in the last episode. All right, well, let's actually get going with what we need to do here. I wish I had a smoke on my team, or a smoke, so that I could not a cigarette, obviously, but like one of the smoke items. So that I could try and not meet as many enemies in this area, because I mean, Sten's by himself, and he's got to kind of fend for himself here in these next few areas. His defense is not that high. Let me check out Sten. His defense is only at 73. And unfortunately, I can't put him, quote-unquote, put him in the back. To take less damage, which is kind of weird. And this is a weird area, because we go through a lot of places where there will be enemies and then no enemies. It's kind of weird. And we get another Tolan. I should probably organize. Well, actually, no, wait. We'll do that here in a second. So, like, this area, there's no enemies, so we don't have to worry about it. But, like I said, we'll be alternating between areas with no enemies and areas with enemies. And here we get a D earring. I don't know if that's... Well... So, we can... let's see what that item does. It gets rid of sleepiness. So, it essentially protects us from the sleep status ailment, which is a good thing, because Sten's by himself, and he can't really fend for himself. So, maybe we call it the dream earring? I don't know. Now, getting through this part of the game and this area does require a little bit of luck. So, if your levels aren't quite high enough, or if you die once or twice, you know, it's certainly not the end of the world. I'm going to do my best to not die, because... Well, dying's a bad thing. So go up here. And we get $1,000. Excellent. Definitely gonna need that money. Yeah, whenever we're in this dungeon area, or we hear this creepy dungeon music, whee! Then we have a chance of running into some enemies. And if you look also, the guy up there, he's dancing a little bit, so there's a small chance. So the encounter rate's not going to be that high. Yeah, but it's there. Okay, this enemy's pretty easy. The pollen, we've dealt with that guy before. Spark! Yeesh. Alright, and no problems there. But believe me, the enemies will get much more difficult. Okay, now anytime you have a chance, refill your HP. And just trust me on that one. Even if it's a health bottle, and you only need to recover like 20 points of life or whatever. Hey, wait a minute. There's Ryu and Blue and Spar. What are they doing there? Well, we gotta try and find them and get to them. Okay. Now let me take a second before we go on in this part. Okay. So let's keep on moving. I'm gonna go this way. And there's some pretty powerful enemies that we're gonna have to deal with here. So, okay, here's a new enemy here. The Pharaoh. And believe me, this guy has some pretty powerful attacks. He can freeze you. He's got a bunch of cold spells. He can cast Rotten Breath on you. It's pretty dangerous. Alright, good shot there, Sten. Very good. The enemy you really want to watch out for down here is an enemy called the Deathbringer. he can pretty much get a critical hit on you every time. I wonder what this is. Whoa! Hey, it's a transporter! And it transported us to a different part of the dungeon. And, woo! Now we're behind the castle. And we see all the guards here. Okay, so there is a secret passage behind the throne room there. Kind of like in the original Dragon Warrior. The secret passage. You remember that area behind Dragon Lord's throne there? And we want to go up this way first. By the way, one thing I will say about this area, and I can't remember if I mentioned this before, ooh, we get a ninja dart, is that it might take you one or two tries. Yeah, good increase in attack power and luck, so we definitely want to put that on. It may take you one or two tries to get through this area because the enemies here are difficult, and Stin is by himself. So if you die, you know, it happens, don't worry about it, just keep on trying. Or if you want to just do some level grinding, we get a cloak knife for Rand. If you want to do some level grinding, you certainly can. This is an okay place to do it, especially with that fountain right there at the beginning that restores your HP and MP. And while there aren't a whole lot of random battles here, there's enough to make your life difficult. Okay, here's a new enemy here. The Golden Sludge. Now, you want to take this thing out as quickly as possible, or a Sea Sludge. I don't know what that stands for, but... yeah, you want to take them out because, yeah, they give a lot of experience. Ooh, and Sten gained a level. Fantastic. And I definitely need him to be gaining a level. Okay, let's use the W Fruit. And now, heal up. Alright, very good. And we get some more money. Yeah, those Sea Sludges are pretty cool. So try and take them out whenever you can. And we just got another pollen enemy, so no problem there. Very good. Yeah, we needed that level up badly to increase our stats, for sure. Okay, let's head up this way. And up here. And, ha-ha! Found her! Oh, the castle can regain the power. Oh... wait, so Shupukay wants to take over the world. Oh, I see. So they only fight when they need to. Well, I don't know about that. No, my name is not Yeah, it's me. Oh, and the princess finally recognizes Sten. Hey, yep. I'm back. That way, ain't no war can stop me. Yep, sure could. Yeah, we sure are. Yeah, just because you have that spiky pink hair and that nice dress is... Ho-ho-ho! Hell yeah! And now it's on! Damn it! Another trap. Man, he fell into that like a sucker. What is? A trap floor is insignificant? But hey! Yo! Fortunately, he didn't land right on Blue. That would have been awful, because Blue would have kicked his ass. Yeah. Ooh. Yeah, that's the... they all gave him the pissed off look. Oh my goodness. Thank God, now we have our whole party back. And much needed, too. Okay, so I switched my party around, so now we've got Ryu in the lead again. Alright, wait. Oh, of course I have to have Sten for this part. Alright. Alright, Sten, do your thing. Thank you. And have us all cross this giant pit. Let's see. Manual. Okay. And what kind of, yeah, I want a normal formation. Stop it. Normal formation. There we go. Okay, very good. Alright. Now let's go up this way. Oh, boy. And basically, we just need to follow the path here. So, let's see. Let's go up this way. And we have some... Oh, basilisks. Yeah, I remember these guys from before. But fortunately, we have all of our party members back, so... We should be able to take these guys out pretty quickly. And I think the death spell worked pretty well against the other one of them. Yeah, so... Alright, there we go. And how is it that even these guys have more speed than Stint? There you go, good shot there, Ryu. Yeah, it's fine, debuff me all you want. Ain't gonna matter, sucker! Oh, it didn't even work. Fantastic. Go blue! There you go, nice shot. Haha! Excellent. Ooh, a lot of experience there. Well, I guess there's more party members now, so that's good. All right. And I believe the path to this is pretty linear. Okay, now we have another one of these sea sludges. So we want to try and take him out as quickly as possible. Take out the pollen. All right, blue. Do your S-boom there. So we can take out those pawns pretty quickly. And let's have him use Spark against the Sea Sludge, and use Cold against the Sea Sludge. Now, hope the Sea Sludge doesn't run away. Perfect! Excellent. There you go. Nicely done. And now Blue will deal with the rest. Oh! Oh, well. Well, I was hoping Blue would be able to take them all out, but that's alright. We should be able to finish this off. There you go. Man, that was like a defend attack from the 7th Saga. That didn't really work. Yeah, a lot of experience. Ooh, and we gained some new spells there. Very nice. Now, with Spar, having Spar on your team is very nice because she can heal up everything. Heal up everybody often. And it won't put a... It will hardly put a dent in her MP. So that's good. Okay, now we want to go here, I think. Oh, it's a good thing I didn't go to the... We can go to the left there. And we have a new enemy here, the Raluba. So let's attack this thing. I have a feeling death's not going to work, but I want to try it anyways. Let's get some flame going, and how about some cold? Because I have a feeling these monsters look like they're dead monsters. So my guess is that they're not susceptible to instant death, but I do want to try it. But if they are dead, they're probably weak to fire. Yeah, pretty close. Yeah, see, that's what I thought. Yeah, if they're dead, they're probably not going to be susceptible to... Alright, hopefully this will... No, come on, miss! Ugh, got two of our characters, so it's not too bad. Go, Blue! There you go, nice shot. A good amount of experience. Having Blue on the team is just so helpful. Okay, now do we have a... No. It looks like I'll have to use some items, but unfortunately I have some antidotes, so we're good. Alright, very good. Now down here... I want to try and make it to that... Wait. Am I doing this right? I think I'm doing this right. And just some more of those Relubas there. Nothing too major. Heal up after that one. Yeah, so much healing we can do without putting a dent in our AP. Okay, now we have a couple Pharaohs here, so let's see what we can do against these guys. They're probably dead as well. So let's just... Let's use physical attacks to take them out. Because again, I'm not too worried about... Oh! Ooh, I hate that. Okay, she got... I only got one of them, unfortunately. I think it turns him into a zombie for like one round or so. Yeah, good shot there, Blue. Boom! What kind of an attack is that, anyway? Okay, survive this! Can you survive this? Yeesh. Yeah, so it turned him into a zombie. I hope it didn't cancel the transformation. That would kind of suck. Ah, it did. Crap. Well, that's alright. I got what I needed out of Spar being a shame in there. So that's okay. That's fine. Okay, let's go up this way now. And just a couple pharaohs there, no problems. And now here, and down, and we can finally get out of this area. And we gain another level for Spar there. Excellent. Oh, man. Okay. Let's keep going. Oh, now we gotta find that door. And another level for Sten. Man, that flame spell is just so useful in this area. I mean, it's just... Let's see. Yeah, might as well heal Ryu there. Yeah, just so useful to take out those pharaohs. Head up this way. And now up here. Okay, and we'll keep going this way. Now, we want to avoid that path for right now and go up this way. I believe... And after that last battle with the Rubalubas, I got an item that was dropped. A Skull BR. It has strange powers. Let's see what we can do with it. My guess is it protects against instant death. I can't confirm that, but I think that's what it does. So that'll be good to have drawn Ryu, so that he can revive anybody that might have died. Whew! A healing pool. Thank goodness. We needed that for sure. Now again, here's another spot to do some level grinding, if you really need to. And we regained our strength, which is actually appropriate, because that's what you do here. And we get a moon mask. So let's equip that on Sten, because he's going to need a big increase in defense, and he needs it. So let's see if we can... Yeah, so actually Sten will take less damage than Blue now, so that's... Well, maybe not necessarily, but... Oh well. Okay, very good. Okay. And okay. So now we need to make our way to the center there and go up those stairs. Man, I'm almost out of antidotes. Okay, I am out of antidotes. I don't get poisoned anymore. Okay. Now we want to go... Looks like this way. And another level for Spar. And Shaheen moved up to level 16. And now we can hold the enemy. So that can be kind of useful. And another level for Ryu. So he's now at level 22. Fantastic. Hey, I can see the stairs! Yeah, now we have a new enemy here, the Soul Flick. Okay, let's see if we can... My guess is... I would think that Freeze would be the way to go, since he seems to be a fire-based enemy. But, you know, that just seems logical, so I don't know how much that will actually make sense, but let's give it a shot. I like it much better when we're able to freeze our enemies and have them not freeze us. There we go. Yeah, decent amount of experience, too, for a pretty easy enemy. That's always good. Kind of like those sea sledges, except sea sledges give a lot more experience, like 1,500 experience. All right. And now we're here in this room. Ooh, we've got three flashing tiles. Okay. Let's see. And when left, if we go to the left and the right, it'll take us to places we've already been. So, let's go up here. Oh, my goodness. What happened here? It's Trubo. What happened? A strong force field on it. I'm not acting like a big shot, man. I'm here to help you. That's badass, man. Sten just beat the crap out of him. I love it. You're damn right I did. All right, but now we have to break the force field on this door. Can we do it and stop Shukay once and for all? You'll have to wait till next time to find out. Till then, this is BCS Buster signing off. Don't forget to like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter at BCS Buster LP, check out the donations page, and as always, take care, y'all.